Hello friend, welcome to my channel Dream Catcher. Today we will discuss about the subject that is introduction to forestry. The first we will discuss that forest word is derived from the Latin word that is forest, which means outside the village boundary. What is the definition of forest? The forest is defined as an area set aside for the production of timber and other forest produce or maintained under other woody vegetation for the certain indirect benefit which it provides. And the certain indirect benefit which it provides, its example is climatic and protective. Then what is the ecological definition of forest? It is defined as plant community predominant of trees and other woody vegetation, usually with a closed canopy. Legal definition of forest. It is defined as an area proclaimed to be forest under forest law. Forest in simple term is defined as an area covering practically all uncultivated and untended lands, fairly extensive stretch of land covered with rather tall and dense tree growth. Now we will discuss about the role of the forest. Mainly there are three types of role a forest play. First one is productive role, second one is protective role, and third one is regulative role. We will discuss only the brief idea of this topic in this video, and the detailed idea of this topic we will discuss in our upcoming videos. So first one is productive role. Productive role includes forest, clothing, shelter, timber, firewood, fodder, minor forest products or non-timber products, etc. First one is food. All living organisms directly or indirectly get food from the forest. Clothing. Most of the clothings are made from the forest-based products. Some organisms even directly use forest products to make their clothing. Shelter. As we know, it provides shelter to a huge amount of organism. Timber, it is very useful for the timber based industries. Our furnitures, etc. are also made up of timber that we get from the forest. Forest also provide firewood, which help us to generate heat, light, etc. It is also very much useful for the fodder for the domestic and wild animals, and for the better production of milk, butter, meat, etc. Minor forest products, or it is also called as non-timber products, are resins, gums, tannins, medicine, minerals and other products like honey, silk, cotton, etc. Now we will discuss about the protective role. In protective role, first topic is climatic factor. Forest help us to maintain temperature, radiation, wind velocity, wind movement, humidity, precipitation within the forest and the surrounding adjoining it. Second factor is adaptive factor, an abiotic factor related to the physical or chemical composition of the soil found in a particular area. It includes soil composition and structure, soil temperature, water table, soil chemistry and soil moisture. Adaptive factor is mainly related with the soil related components. Third one is hydrological factor. It includes evaporation, transpiration, infiltration, subsoil runoff and siltation of river beds. And other factor related in protective roles are forest protects from air pollution, protects us from noise pollution. It is a huge source of biodiversity conservation, very important. And one more important is carbon sequestration. It holds a huge amount of carbon, which can be responsible for greenhouse effect and thus global warming. Thus, it conserves and holds that much of carbon under them. And last is rehabilitation of mined area. Now we will discuss about the regulative roles. First one is ameliorating climate.
Ameliorating means sudharna, means to improve the climate of that area and the surrounding area near the forest. Second one is climatic change. Third one is wind. Fourth one is air temperature maintenance. And fifth one is precipitation. And sixth one is soil and water conservation.
Our next topic is direct benefit of forest. Under this, first one is food. Since time immemorial, forest is providing food to the organism inhabited in the forest. And since today, we are getting a huge amount of food products from the forest. Second one is clothing. Primitive people still collects their clothing from forest directly, but we are using forest product to manufacture our clothes. Third one is shelter. Provides shelter to its inhabitants, and woods are used still to make houses. Fourth one is fuel. Fuel. Forest is good source of firewood used in different industries for production of heat, etc. Then raw materials for industries. Forest provide various raw materials for the industries. Then is medicinal plants. Forest provide useful medicine plants, roots, leaves, bark, etc. used for the production of medicines. Other necessary products that we get from forest are nuts, chicle, sandalwood, oil, turpentine, cinnamon, etc. Bark of various trees provide cork. Some leaves supply material for beverages, cosmetic, drugs, fiber, etc. Nuts are used for making buttons and oil extraction. Rubber is derived from the latex of hevea tree. Rosewood oil is collected from rosewood tree and used for perfume making. Balata for cable making. Wax resins, honey and gums or chicles, tannin, etc. are other important products of the forest. Next topic we will discuss, that is indirect benefit of forest. First, it influences on climate. Water table of the area is influenced by transpiration process and extraction of underground water through roots, and thus helps to maintain the temperature around the forest. Second one is influence on soil. Holding soil firmly, roots of the tree prevent soil erosion and denudation of soil. It also checks alluvial erosion. It is the erosion mainly by wind. Then lack of forest cover or deforestation accelerates soil erosion that leads to landslides and change of river course. Formation of soil is also related to forest cover. Plant leaves after decomposition produce organic matter and nitrogen content of the soil. The next one is influence on natural disaster. Forest cover is a natural protection of an area from many natural calamities and disaster. Next is desertification. Plant development of forest area may check further increase of desert land and conversion of barren desert land to fertile agriculture land. Next topic is recreational travel and tourism. Far from the madding and maddening crowd, forests are a natural attraction to the tourist. Preserved and protected forests and sanctuaries now attract millions of tourists, which benefits a country economy in many ways. Native people can sell their wares to the tourist, be their guides, provide foods and shelter to obtain much needed income. Thank you for watching my video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel.